NBA 2K My League fans. I'm back with another NBA 2K My League expansion series video with those Cincinnati Lions. And you can look at the screen here, you can see that the conference semifinals matchups are set. You got the top seed Lakers out west against the Clippers for the Battle of LA. You got the Minnesota Timberwolves and the San Antonio Spurs, both who went seven games in their first round matchup. And in the east, you got the top seeded Bulls against the Bucks, who beat the MVP-led Sean Rook's Brooklyn Nets after a seven-game series there. And then you got the Pacers against the shocking Cincinnati Lions, who upset the Miami Heat in the first round and totally dominated those guys 4-1. And we got highlights of game one in this video. We're going to take a look at the stat leaders after round one. We're going to take a look at the conference semifinals game one results from the other three series. And we're going to kind of preview our series with the Pacers, look at the what happened during the year. Probably a little bit more, too. If you're new to the channel, I'm Coach 2K. If you're new to the channel, you're going to want to subscribe and click the bell to get notified whenever I upload anything new. I'll put a link in the series in the corner at the beginning of the series so you can start it from the very beginning. All right, so the playoff leaders after round one. Look at that. Donnell Jenks leading the league in the playoffs in scoring 37 points a game. 22 years old from Miami of Florida. Look at that. He's got three 40-point games in a row as he has been the superstar for the Cincinnati Lions and really looking like the superstar of the playoffs so far. All right, so rebounds per game. Sean Rooks led the league in reboundings in the first round. Billups, look at that. He's number three at 14 a game. Sean Rooks was the league MVP this year. And you can see he's a seven-footer. He once, in that series against Milwaukee, which they lost, he had 25 rebounds in one of those games and had a triple-double, and that 25-rebound game was nearly a triple-double game. Xavier Jamison leading the league in steals, or I'm sorry, assists at 10 a game. Look at that. Right behind him, Calvin Hood. The Clippers, they did a pretty good job getting into the second round. I didn't think that they would do that, but there's a look at some of Xavier Jamison's stats. He's a pretty solid assist man. He looks like he's a two-way player here, and playmaker, I suppose, probably a better term for him. All right, Byron Dantley, look at that, steals per game. He is leading the playoffs in steals per game. Byron Dantley, a guy we got our eye on in free agency. Pretty good player. He is going to be a handful in this series. You can look at the last game they played. He put up 42, 14, and 6. So the guy can score. He can do it all. Look at a couple blocks, too. He had 7 blocks, looks like, in that one game. Leading the league in blocks, Sharon Thabeet at, 3.3 a game. 7-footer. A strong interior defender. He got more. Well, I guess Rooks tied him, so Rooks definitely was up there. You can hear it some of his stats the last few games in the playoffs. So they're going to need that when they play LA, the top-ranked team in the league with home court advantage. So we'll see how the Clippers fare against the Lakers. I'm anxious to see how that series plays out. All right, so in the first game of the conference semis, the Bulls ended up beating the Bucks. Oden had a bunch of points there, 16, 18 points, 14 rebounds. I can't see the scores. You'll have to read the box scores. But Bulls hold on to home court in the first game of the series. Marion Wells led the Bucks with 22. Wilt Jones Jr. played pretty well, too. They're pretty tough. I love that Wilt Jones Jr. He is a super player. Marion Wells isn't bad either. The Bucks, though, they lost Linnell Brewer to a dislocated right patella, and he is out for the season. That could hurt them because he's kind of a like an 86-rated player, I think. And you can look at some of his stats there, both in the regular season and in the playoffs. So that's definitely going to hurt them against the Bulls. Bulls should win that series anyway. But we'll see. All right, so the Timberwolves and the San Antonio Spurs. Look at that. The Spurs ended up beating the T-Wolves behind Dunn's performance of, well, that was for the Timberwolves. Dunn had 20, Kingsley 20. But Mitchell, he had 26 points to lead the Spurs to victory in that first game of the series. I'm a little surprised that the T-Wolves didn't take care of business, but they haven't really been playing as well as they have for the I think they once won 18 games in a row in the regular season. Manuel Mitchell, you can see he's from Duke, 88 rated player. Look at some of his stats there. So good job. The Spurs winning, taking home court in the first game from the T-Wolves. And here's a surprise, the Clippers, man. They destroyed the Lakers 101-75. Look at where is Dupree, man? What, 8 points? Hot Rod Dupree did not show up for that game. And on the Clippers side, Eric Rice Jr., he led them to victory. So you got Darren Pack on the team too. He was a former Lion. But anyway, the Clippers, a surprise out west, take game one. Look at Eric Rice there. Look at some of his stats. 80 rated player from LSU, Eric Rice Jr. Well, congrats to the Clippers. We'll see if they can continue that. I kind of expect the Lakers to bounce back. The Lakers did lose Marion Rodman for 6 to 8 weeks with a pulled right calf muscle. And that's a big loss for them. He's a double-double guy. That could have something to do with why the Lakers lost the first game of the series. So we'll see what happens there. Looks like Rodman's going to be out at least for this series, probably the whole thing. Darren Pack, former Lion, broke his nose, but he's probably still playing. I think he played a little bit in that game anyway. We'll see if he keeps playing with the broken nose, but it says he's going to be out 1 to 2 weeks. All right, so we're going to play the Pacers. The Pacers were the second team in the West, the second seed. They finished a game or two behind, 2 games behind the Bulls. They're led by Byron Dantley, a two-way star. This guy is incredible. He is a free agent this year, and half the league is interested in him. So he'll probably end up re-signing with the Pacers. He thought, just like Gary Henderson did in the first round, that he should have been the MVP. He should have been the Defensive Player of the Year. And, I would say Byron Dantley has a case. I mean, second seed in the East. And Lonzo Gatson made the all-rookie team. He was bummed he didn't get Rookie of the Year. Lonzo Gatson, he's a really nice player. He can shoot the three, and he's a pretty good power forward. I enjoyed using him when I played them in another series. I'll put a link to that in the corner if I remember to do that. All right, so during the year, we played the Pacers 4 times, and we got swept 4-0. And so you can see we got pounded in the first one, 112-88. Byron Dantley, he scored 42 points, 11 rebounds, and they were just incredible. We could not stop them at all. I think it was an alley-oop fest. I'll put a link in the corner to one of the games with the Pacers so you can see just what it was like. Then we played them in Indiana, and they were hot from three. They totally destroyed us, 142-120. Bo Warwick with 41, Dantley with 37. And Gatson with 20, as they were incredibly on fire in that game. They just hit it from everywhere. In this game, we had Donnell Jenks for the first time against the Pacers. And he did not disappoint. He put up 51, even though, we lost by 22. Good performance by Jenks and Drew. Both who were pretty new to the team probably at that time. So, third game of the year. We came close, but we got beat. And Dantley again scored, 37 points. Warwick with 29. Those guys, that's a tough backcourt. I mean, they are strong. They can shoot. They can score. Jenks scored 43. Phillips had 20 and 18. And in the end, though, they would take that game as well. And so we had a tough time matching up with these guys. And then in the final game of the season, against the Pacers, we showed up a little bit better. Jenks had 36 points or something like that, and we ended up losing by 6 as they pulled away at the end and ended up taking all four games from us. They only had 41 in that game. Warwick with 27. And so, as you can see, this game here, this series here, could prove tough to us because we don't match up very well. They're a better defensive team, I think, than the Miami Heat. So we're anxious to get on the court here. You can see Donnell Jenks, 37 points a game. And the team scoring 121 a game in the playoffs. Pretty good scoring output. Byron Dantley, 26 points a game. And they're averaging about 120 points a game as a team, too. So both teams can score. And so in the playoffs, you got to have defense, but you got to be able to score, too. So look at the playoff atmosphere in Indiana. I've been in that playoff atmosphere in the Pacers Arena many times, and it's an awesome feeling. Our starting lineup, we're able to keep the same starting lineup intact. No injuries really to speak of for either team. One of the role players is hurt for the Pacers, but that's not going to affect them. All right, so here we go. We're going to tip off the conference semifinals. The tip goes to the Pacers here, and they get the ball to their superstar, Byron Dantley, right away. You can see he's going to try and take advantage of us. I thought he had Bo Warwick there open, and he missed him. And here off the screen, well, they're not going to use the screen. Look at Bo Warwick trying. We're trying to play good D, but they get it to Bryce Kidd in the corner, who shows his range and gets the Pacers on the board and knocks down the three. And then right on the other end, Yang Zhang does the same thing for us, and they get Bryce Kidd gets blocked by Eddie Drew. We couldn't convert it on the other end. But look at the defense by Zhang as he played pretty good D, and then Dantley got him off his feet, drew the foul. He's going to go to the line and get a couple shots here to try and tie the game at 5-all early. Get a good look at Dantley there. And hits the first one. As you know, I kind of like to look at the presentation of the game too. And you'll see here in a minute how important it is that I do that, because it's going to see something pretty cool. All right, so we're throwing it into Billups here. And he's going to go in the post against Semi Bayo and score. And Calvin Hood gets into the lane. He gets it to Eddie Drew. Eddie Drew finishes inside. So we're off to a decent start here. And they get it to Bryce Kidd. And in traffic, he hits the layup on the fast break. Nice play here as we get it to Zhang. And he pivots around and scores it off the glass. And on the break here, we get, look at that, Austin Billups with the dunk. 13-9, and Billups with another one. One of the things I noticed about a lot of these games is guys kind of get in a rhythm, and they'll score like several times in a row. And look at Dantley getting around us, and he schools Donnell Jenks. There's Alonzo Gadsden with the, I think, a long two. And look at the find. We got Jonathan Myers, the backdoor cut, the slam dunk. And we got an 8-point lead here early. Look at Bo Warwick burying a three. And I couldn't resist putting a little Boomer in here. Check out Boomer's show here at the end of the first quarter, showing off to the crowd. I think Boomer made the Mascot Hall of Fame the other day, if I recall hearing it correctly. So a little Boomer action there as he's putting on a show for the crowd. Boomer's a pretty good mascot. You see Zhang get the pass and dunk it in the lane. And look at the bench, man. We got a 9-point lead. There, we tip the pass. We're going to get out in transition. We're going to get it to Eddie Drew. And the pass got tipped and went back to Eddie Drew, back to the offense on our side this time. And he scores. There, the ball gets tipped around. And wide open underneath is Rayshon Holmes, who gets the dunk. And is he going to convert the M1? He does. And so look at Byron Dantley getting inside. And that's where he's deadly. And look at this dunk by Donnell Jenks. He caught Dantley snoozing. And no, that wasn't Dantley. That was, I think that was Jedovic that he got. Now, you ever see Byron Dantley get right here on the elbow, man? He's taking you. And he does there. Nice job by him. Nice find here as Donnell Jenkins misses the shot. But look at the putback slam by 00. And I think at the end of the season, we're going to give him a new number. 00 if we can do it. And inside, is that Dantley? No, that's Bryce Kidd. Good score by Bryce Kidd. Oh, got the alley-oop. What a great alley-oop to Dantley. Check this out, man. Reverse. Nice job. Oh, we're going to run Jenks off the screen to shoot a three-pointer. And so he's proven he can not only dunk, but he can also shoot the three when at certain times. There we get fooled, but we get the big block. And look at the Myers gets to Jenks, and Jenks does the 360 two-handed slam in transition. Look at this, man. Nice job. That's a slam dunk contest dunk in the conference semifinals. Another alley-oop to Byron Dantley off the inbounds play as they go right at us. There, oh, this is a big moment here. Look at this. There's a tie-up, and look, there's a little confrontation here with Donnell Jenks and Dantley. Donnell Jenks pushes him. No technical or anything. The guys kind of went back to their corners. And immediately right after that, Donnell Jenks scores and gives us a 12-point lead. That was a pretty amazing outburst there. As we get it to 00, Jenks finds him rolling to the basket, and he scores. Good look at the camera from the backboard. And there, Semi Bayo with the shot fake gets it into Bryce Kidd. Bryce gets the phantom foul. He says, I can't hear you, crowd. Come on, let's get into it. We need you. We need the sixth man. And Bryce Kidd goes to the line, converts the and-one opportunity, cuts the lead down to 11. And there you're going to find Bryce Kidd again going through a stretch here where he's scoring. And so here, nice play here as we get Donnell Jenks finds Eddie Drew rolling to the basket. And he scores. Look at the bench. Everybody's excited. And they're going to post up. Zing. We did tip the pass. Donnell Jenks did. But it went back to the offense. And Dantley ended up scoring. There we got out of position. Bo Warwick, I think, scored. Look at the crowd starting to get into it with the yellow gold out, as we call it in Indiana. And here, the nice steal by Jonathan Myers going the distance with the slam dunk. He hammered that one. Look at this dunk here, both hands behind the head. And then we find Zhang at the end of the second quarter gives us a 12-point lead after he hits the three. Jenks with 16, Kidd with 15. 12-point lead at the half on the road. That's a surprise. I was a little surprised. You get a look at downtown Indianapolis. And so we're starting the second half here as Bo Warwick gets the Pacers on the board. And we got Donnell Jenks again. He got double teamed and he immediately found Calvin Hood for the three. And Calvin Hood, he doesn't get many shots, but he does come through for us. And here Donnell Jenks finds Zhang for another spot up three after a drive and kick. And we're going to get Daddy Drew with the mid-range. He misses it. But check out the effort by Donnell Jenks as he gets the offensive rebound in front of the juker there. And this is the kind of night it was for the Pacers. They just could not hit what they normally do. And we get it to Jenks, who gets it to Drew. Drew catches it, throws it in, and now we're up by 22. I can't believe we're up 22. You see the move by Dantley. As he started to go, hey, we need to start playing here. Look at this play here. The Jenks pass to Billups, and Billups, he missed the dunk. We got fouled, but Semi Bayo is hot, man. And Billups goes to the line after they try and calm Bayo down. And he gets the first one. Nice job. Our free throw shooting has improved over the course of the season. We struggled a lot missing free throws. We'll probably still miss quite a few, but look at the defense here. Nice defense as we're holding tight, and we get the rebound here after Bryce Kidd can't shake us. We get it to Donnell Jenks, and check this out as he goes the distance with the dunk. No, but right there in Dantley's face, Dantley moved out of the way. He didn't want to be posterized. Well, at least not directly there. This is a shot by Drew, but look again at the effort. Donnell Jenks is everywhere, picking up the Eddie Drew mess and putting it back in front of Dantley, who didn't show the effort there. And here's Lonzo Gatson. Nice shot inside. But still, we're way up, 22. There we get the steal as we see the pass coming. And they get it to Jonathan Myers ahead of everybody with another monster slam. And you can see Dantley couldn't stop it. Pretty good play there. Nice cut to the basket by the Juker here. Semi Bayo, I think, finds him. And another alley-oop in the game to Jonathan Myers with another dunk from Double O. Double O's turned out to be a pretty reliable passer. And look at Gatson, man. Gatson passing this round, showing why he made the all-rookie team. And we get to Bonzi Harris, who's cutting to the basket. He catches the tip pass. Watch it get tipped a little bit. There he bobbles it. Gets control, puts it in. And they're going back in the post to Dantley. And we can't guard that. Dantley's like, all right, I got it under control here. As you can see, a nice play there. We did good, not getting the step back. But then look at that dunk by Barry. You should see Barry in the All-Star weekend matchup. I'll try and remember to put a link in the corner to that video. There's a nice dunk there. But Barry had a pretty good All-Star weekend. And good find here by the CPU. As we overplayed, Warwick coming out. That left the Juker wide open underneath. You see Gatson again getting into the lane and scoring. But we're still up 20 here. And look at Warwick popping the three. He would struggle tonight. Had a really poor shooting performance. I kind of think they took us lightly. As you see Jedovic get to the lane. And Gatson gets the dish. And he ducks it. And we get... Is that Billups? Yeah, Billups with a tough shot. As you can see from the highlight here, he kind of keeps his eye on the basket and throws it over his head. Good finish there. Bo Warwick. But look at the big block by Billups, man. He is controlling the lane. And everybody got back, so we didn't have anything. We kind of forced it a little bit. So we're going to set it up here and see what we can get out of this. Throw it around to Drew. A little swing action. And throw it to Zing at the top. He ends up being wide open. And that's an easy shot for Zing most of the time. Looks like they score inside with Jedovic that time. And there. Tough shot. Played good D. He forced it anyway. Bayo gets the rebound and scores. Let's see. Oh, look at this play by Myers. And look at this dish. This pass by Calvin Hood. Good job by him. That reminds me earlier, Jedovic threw a pass behind the head to Gatson, a flashy pass as Zing scores on the break. And they get that Semi Bayo inside with a nice dunk. As they made a little bit of a run, but we were able to withstand it. I think they got it down to 14 at one point. Look at the dunk by Warwick, but it misses. And I think that's Bayo scores. Bayo's a good player. I like him. Look at Dantley out in front of everybody with a monster slam of his own. There it is, down to 14. We call timeout to try and regroup. And we're going to go to our man here, to Donnell Jenks, and try and get us an easy score. We do with the dunk. And now we're up by 16 again as they find the Juker. He finishes the layup. Look at this play here by... Oh my gosh, Donnell Jenks, check out the 360 two-handed slam. That's his second one of the game, man. As Kidd goes to the lane, Billups gets the block. They're going to get it to Jenks, and check out Jenks again. Another dunk with authority, and he has really put his stamp on this game. And what a performance. I can't believe how well he has done. As we let time run out, and we end up winning by 19. And we take home court from the Pacers. As we lead this series now 1-0. And the Pacers are like a little bit shell-shocked, I think. As you see Jenks and the team rallying around each other. We did turn it over a lot, but we shot extremely well, like we usually do. You look at some of the stats there. I mean, we killed them on the offensive glass. They did not shoot very many threes. That's where they killed us one game earlier in the year. I mean, they just destroyed us from three. Everything they shot went in. And here we caught them on an off shooting night. Plus, we played some pretty good defense. There were some blocks and defense I didn't even put in the highlights. You see, Daly had 24 points, Warwick 18, Kidd with 15, Gatson with 10. And, you know, they were, you know, look at that, 7 of 27 for Warwick, as he did not play very well. And on our side, Jinx had 34, 8, and what, 9? I mean, he was starting to flirt with triple-doubles here, which is great. Zing had 24, 4 of 9 from 3. Myers had a good performance. Billups and Drew, both double-doubles. As we take game one, and there's how the playoffs sit after one game, and we are going to prepare for game two to see if we can take a 2-0 lead on these Pacers and somehow take it by surprise. I am Coach 2K. I'll see you on the court in the next video. Thanks for watching and stay healthy.